So I've been a Windows user my whole life until just about a year and a half ago when I switched to a base M1 MacBook Air with just 8 gigs of RAM and 256 gigs of SSD. This 2020 MacBook Air still blows me away how good the battery life is while also being able to easily handle all my photo and video editing. Even with just 8 gigs of RAM, I smoothly edit in 4K with a bunch of browser tabs and windows open in the background. It really runs my YouTube channel. With all this talk about the new Snapdragon X Elite chipset and Microsoft apparently finally figuring out emulation for Windows on ARM, I was super hyped to go back to Windows and see if my photo and video editing workflow still works well on Samsung's new Galaxy Book 4 Edge. I already did a bunch of testing and here's everything that I found out. So just to set expectations, Windows 11 ARM has a brand new translation layer called Prism. It's supposed to act just like Rosetta on macOS to emulate x86, x64 software on Windows 11 ARM devices. Emulation was straight up horrible on previous Windows on ARM devices because they were both underpowered and the emulation was just so slow. Most apps that had to be emulated ran really badly and there just wasn't enough ARM optimized software back then on Windows. In terms of benchmarks and raw power, the new Snapdragon X Elite chip essentially matches Apple's M3 chipset, which says a lot about how powerful this new platform is. And overall, for emulating apps that aren't ARM native, we're generally seeing just a 10 to 15% performance drop, which is pretty good. By the way, this 14-inch Galaxy Book 4 Edge here has the 8100, which is the 12-core middle option within the X Elite lineup. But this promising performance also comes with a lot of caveats. While most pieces of software and day-to-day computing will work perfectly fine on this Windows ARM laptop, creative apps are very iffy on what's compatible or what will even emulate at all. For example, a lot of reviewers who got the early units were able to test the non-ARM version of Adobe Premiere Pro with their Snapdragon X Elite devices, but Adobe has since blocked access to installing Premiere for Windows on ARM. Adobe has announced a native ARM beta coming soon, but we'll probably have to wait a few months for that. As of filming this video, only Photoshop and Lightroom are actually available to download through Adobe Creative Cloud. On the other side, the ARM version of DaVinci Resolve 19 is available, but is still a beta, so you have to keep that in mind. So before I even get to the actual performance, you can already see that this is definitely an early adopter type of device for creatives right now. So for the creative apps that do work right now, how do they actually perform? Starting off with photo editing, Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop both launched really fast. Even compared to super powerful desktop PCs or M3 MacBook Pros, the app launch times for both apps were very comparable. First, I imported about 1 gig of raw image files from my Galaxy phone into the laptop directly via USB-C. It took just about 30 to 40 seconds to finish, a tiny bit longer than expected, but pretty normal speeds. When importing to Lightroom, cropping, transforming, and making edits on the photos, the UI works just as you would expect. It feels exactly like how it would actually perform on a powerful PC or on a MacBook Air or Pro. Even when I apply tweaks to all the raw images, the applying and rendering time is super quick. What I did notice was that the Book 4 Edge already got pretty warm right above the keyboard even before exporting. When I did export, I exported 31 images at 100% quality in JPEG and it took just about 30 to 40 seconds, which is pretty quick. Similar story with Photoshop, the app is very responsive. There are no weird stutters when moving around images or even using generated fill. Perfectly smooth for all the photo editing you have to do. Doing a single project on Photoshop isn't that taxing, so the laptop didn't get warm, which is good. For both apps, the fans were silent the entire time. There is some kind of very subtle whine sometimes if you put your ears close, but you really can't hear it if you're using your laptop like a normal person. And of course, Edge and Chrome are fully ARM native, so using creative apps like Canva is no problem at all if that's what you're looking for. Just for context, during my approximately 1 hour of light photo editing using all those apps above, the laptop sipped just under 10% of battery, which is pretty promising. Then for video editing, like I said earlier, what we can test out right now is the ARM beta version of DaVinci Resolve. Even for a beta, things look relatively smooth at first. App launch time is the same experience as what you would expect with Apple Silicon laptops. Importing, cutting, playback, and multiple tracks, it's all relatively smooth and responsive as expected. At first start, I was like, this is it. Windows on ARM is finally at parity. But once I hit the 30-minute mark, that's when I saw that this is still a beta and started to run into many, many bugs. Resolve suddenly becomes unresponsive, which honestly isn't uncommon on Mac either, but after it comes back, imported files are now not being recognized. Some clips glitch so much you can't even view them anymore. Then sometimes Resolve becomes totally unresponsive and just shuts down on you. The first time it really crashed on me, it wouldn't even launch anymore. I tried multiple software reinstalls, hard reboots, etc, etc, and yes, all my drivers, software, firmware were all updated before any of these bugs. After a full system reset, it started to work again, but also with similar bugs after about 30 minutes or so. I was able to successfully finish editing a YouTube short and export it, but the export time for a 40 second 4K video took just about 1 minute and 30 seconds, which really isn't that impressive. Obviously, this is beta software, and I'm sure Samsung will deliver more driver updates for this laptop, but for right now, the Windows ARM version version of Resolve is not a good experience for video editing just yet. I know it's early to say that, but regular people can go into stores and buy these computers right now, so I did want to share these issues with you guys. The good news is that the battery wasn't getting destroyed during my video editing like how it usually did on any other Windows laptop. So once Resolve is really ready and even better optimized for ARM, I'll definitely be going on nice long editing sessions at cafes outside using this laptop. The funny part is that the simpler video editors like Clipchamp had an easier time dealing with a bunch of 4K footage, so it really does seem to be more of a software issue. I'll definitely test out the upcoming Premiere Pro beta once it comes, and also Resolve again as the beta gets more updates. So stay tuned for an updated video on the same topic in the next few months. So yeah, while we're already seeing some really promising signs in terms of power and battery life from the Snapdragon X Elite chipset and Windows 11 ARM, it's still very early stages for doing creative type of work. For most photographers and photo editors, you'll actually be totally fine taking a chance on a Windows 11 ARM device. Lightroom Classic is missing, which is a bummer, but there's plenty of compatible and optimized apps already, and you're getting very comparable performance in super thin and portable hardware. But for video editing, I really recommend waiting until Blackmagic and Adobe really flesh out their apps. Resolve Beta just isn't ready yet, and Premiere Pro Beta is still yet to come. If you need just light video editing, I mean you have CapCut and Clipchamp or even Canva available right here, so that's not a problem. But if you do need a little more, definitely wait until you hear that these apps are 100% ready and performing okay. So if you want to stay up to date with that, definitely subscribe and stay tuned to the channel for updates on this topic throughout this year. Also, let me know in the comments what you guys want me to test and cover for this laptop in this interesting new ARM landscape. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.